Hi everyone, thank you for joining the DC Public Library for STEM Time. I'm Miss Tara. So today we're talking about fractions, and this is video one, part one, of a two-part series on them. Now fractions is a way for us to look at equal pieces of a whole. And when we're talking about fractions, I find the easiest way to learn about them is by cooking, baking, or by looking at food fractions as we eat our lunches, our dinners, our breakfasts, and snacks. So in this one, we're going to use the kitchen tool measuring cups. And if you've ever seen measuring cups, if you've ever helped your caregivers bake or cook, you might have noticed that they rest inside of each other. These are dry measuring cups. And they rest inside of each other. And they have these fractions written on them. The smallest one says 1/4, 1/4. Some people call that a quarter of a cup. The medium-sized one says 1/2, or a half. And then this cup just says 1, so that's 1 whole cup. So because they nest inside of each other, you can see how they make up the whole. But to bring that point home, we're going to use some chocolate chips and some measuring cups to show how these fractions come together to make up the whole. Now at your house, you're probably going to use water and just a mixing bowl. And the reason I'm not using water is because it doesn't film well. It's going to splash all over and it's going to be difficult for you to see a clear liquid on the camera. So you don't have to have chocolate chips, but if you're choosing to help your caregiver bake, that is a wonderful way to learn fractions. Okay. So I'm picking up the 1/4, the 1/4 cup, also known as a quarter of a cup. And I'm going to put that into the half cup, the 1/2 cup. Do you see there's still room in there? There is. So I'm going to measure one more. That's right. 2 of the 1/4, or quarter of a cup, or they equal the half. So 2 of these equals a half a cup. Okay, now what if I take the half and I pour it into the full 1 cup? Do I still have room? Absolutely. Now I'm going to measure one, an additional 1 of these half cups, and I'm going to pour it in. And of course, see what I mean about being messy? Now, that's right. 2 of the half cups equals 1 whole cup. Exactly. Now, I'm going to just put these in here for now. Now, what if I want to use the quarter cup, the 1/4 cup, to create the 1 cup? How many would I need? Have you figured it out? 1, let's count together. 2, 3, 4. Exactly. I would need 4 1/4 cups or quarter cups in order to create the whole. So my whole was divided into 4 equal parts. Boys and girls, that's letting me know that it's time for us to go. Thank you so much for joining me and DC Public Library for STEM Time. We hope to see you next time. And don't forget to check us out online at dclibrary.org anytime for books, audiobooks, whether audiobooks or ebooks, and all of the resources that we have that you can use at home, as well as games and puzzles and more activities. Take care.
DC Public Library, we are here with you.